Oh, okay. Okay, 1, 2, 3, action. Okay, guys. What is up, guys? Farhan here with Za once again. And we have Chris once again. And this is Chris' other bike. The Gilera Fuco 500. I finally said that right. Yes, right. I pronounce it as Fucho. Fucho.
That is fishball.
Really? Okay, I've never seen this bike before. I've seen it on the internet. And I was like, wow, the design is very nice. It's eye-catching.
This bike is not very common.
Yes, not, it's very, not very common in Singapore. Yes, first time I'm seeing it with my own eyes.
I would say this is like the Ferrari of the scooters, you know.
I think Zah, you're lighting up a bit because you like this bike, right?
Yeah, of course. I mean, by the look of itself in the front, you see, it's so garang, you know. It has that masculine feature.
Careful not to upset the T-Max riders. Okay.
Those are. Yeah. It has a masculine feature, you know, that I like about it. Very rugged look.
Before Chris tell us about his bike, we're gonna give a bit of introduction. So built by Italian manufacturer Piaggio.
Piaggio.
Built by Italian manufacturer Piaggio.
Piaggio.
Piaggio. Gilera's parent. The Gilera Fuco 500 is a three-wheeler maxi scoot marketed for the long highway rides and mountainous routes. The design is bulky and aggressive. It's made to project a presence on the road. So engine is a Euro 3 compliant 492cc liquid cool 4-stroke SOHC with fuel injection and a continuously variable transmission, which is automatic. And like I said before, first time seeing this bike with my own eyes. Usually it's on the internet. And care to tell us why you got the Gilera Fuco?
Okay, because I rode the MP3 125. So that was my first experience with a 3-wheeler. Mm-hmm. So when you ride a 3-wheeler, well, basically you are not afraid of the white lines during wet days, albeit the manholes, because you know
it's very stable.
Yeah, it's just stable. So when I rode the MP3 was excellent, but I knew that if I had more power to that, it would be excellent. So I didn't look at a 400, and I was, when I bought this, I only had class 2A. So I just bought it first and put it home when it came available.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. You tahan this bike how long before you finally got it? You got to ride on it lah, basically. Legally lah.
Three months.
Three months.
Yeah.
Okay lah, not too bad lah.
Okay lah. Maybe class 2 is easy to pass. Right?
Yeah. I knew I'll pass it. Come on.
Just don't bring the bike at the driving center.
No.
That one you really find problem.
Don't ask for trouble.
Yeah. Correct.
How old is this bike currently?
Now it's 8 years. It's 2012.
How much did you buy that time?
I bought it secondhand from one guy who's similar to myself, recreational rider. He had 3 bikes. The 4th bike was coming, so he sold the 3rd one. He sold this to me. I bought it at 12,000.
Mm-hmm. 12,000. Wow. Yeah.
Okay.
But that is a good price for a class 2 actually.
At that time, well, he the funny thing is he asked for 12,000. I went there, I saw it, and then I said okay. So he said, "Hey Chris, it's either you are very decisive or I massively underpriced my bike."
Maybe you will treat him dinner before you bought the bike.
I just took it 2,000.
I have to say, despite it being like 8 years old, it's in such good condition, you know. You really take care of it.
Our friends in JB, for 10 ringgit, it takes care of everything. But since for the last how many months, I haven't showered a poor guy. So you see some.
Because Chris has a car, he has a car actually. So that's why these bikes, the Adiva and the Gilera, isn't really his daily riders. So Chris, don't mind me asking, what is it that you like about the bike?
I like the shape.
Outlook.
Yeah, the shape, the handling. And like I say, because I always ride
three-wheelers,
and it gives me so much confidence on the north-south. When we overtake this one at 135, 140,
stable.
The front is so heavy, it just sticks to the ground. Whatever drift comes to me, I feel nothing. It just slides through. So it's just so firm, this one.
Dad is also a fan of the three-wheeler bikes, you know. After we sold off the MP3, previously I was riding a MP3. He was riding lah. It was under my name. He was riding it. Then we scrap it away. Then now he bought the MP3 400.
Yeah.
actually in the in before he bought the MP3 400, he wanted to buy the Foco also, the the 500cc. So because of the capacity and the power and stability of a three wheeler, so he wanted to get the Foco, but because he couldn't afford it lah. After that, a year later, he bought the MP3 400.
He settled for the MP3 lah, the next best thing lah, basically.
Yes.
But then this Foco I know is very famous in Italy. It's very reputable lah over there.
This is considered one of the uncommon bikes in Singapore.
Yes,
and
yes.
And Gilera being an Italian bike, I'm a fan of Italian bikes. since I passed my license, I've been riding Italian bikes, you know.
Until
the Honda came around. I really like the Gilera series of scooters, you know, because they have very powerful engine compared to other scooters in its class.
You see, sir, are we reviewing the bike or are we reviewing you?
Okay. Let's talk about the bike. The bike is a very powerful engine.
So Chris, don't mind me asking. You told me you went touring with this bike lah.
Yeah.
How far have you went with the Foco?
Not far enough. Not far. Unfortunately, yeah.
But you conquered the mountains, is it, with this bike? The Cameron Highlands, all that. Did you conquer it?
Unfortunately, only to Genting. Of course, I've done a few trips to KL. But we were planning, like, this year we had so many plans. Like, all bike, all riders, everything, all...
Yeah, I agree with you. Yeah. That's why we are stuck doing bike reviews, guys.
But I will take him to further definitely up. Further Thailand, but as far up
hopefully,
as
possible. Yeah. Because I think when I read the reviews about this bike, it's meant to conquer the mountainous hills.
How is the fuel consumption like for this bike?
24-25
kilometers per liter.
Per liter, yeah.
Per liter lah. So full tank, how many?
Also 11 liters.
11 liters also.
Yeah. Like average around.
Yeah.
It's standard lah for a class 2.
For a scooter.
For a scooter, sorry guys.
Yeah, because the tank is average. Under the seat, so... Oh no, the tank is here. So I like this one because when I stop to fill up, you just pop here. You pop it up, then you top up. So all our luggage and stuff is strapped here, you don't need to remove. If the tank is under the seat, then the other bike I gotta remove. It's not funny, right?
No, not funny at all.
So this one won all the way there, so this is my favorite. Okay, so and it's not for sale, guys.
Not for sale, huh? For sale.
Are you going to ride this until the end of the COE?
I think Chris confirm renew.
Oh, yeah.
Chris confirm renew lah.
Yeah, definitely.
Because he loves his bike so much, as you can see the passion in his eyes. Okay, so I just want to ask about storage space. Storage space under the seat?
This is perfect.
Perfect.
My squash rackets can fit under the seat. And with a haversack as well.
Wow. Okay. Later we show. And then in front here, also there's some storage cubbies.
Here don't have. So this one, this one doesn't have.
This one is not. Nothing. It's not. Okay. Yeah.
This one is to tapau your chicken rice and your prawn noodle soup. Or you buy durian, you don't want the smell to go in anywhere, you hang it here.
So we got a GV box right here.
Yeah.
And then other accessories, just the windshield only.
For me it's only this
windshield. Then I noticed that.
Oh yeah, I added this.
What's that?
Foot bags.
Oh my gosh, but it's you're already relaxing already. Why you want to put the foot bag?
This one, when you are on the highway, you so my seat also I cut and shifted back, so it's for one up. So when I'm seated back, I'm just stretched out on these two.
So you just want
the highway.
Yeah. Remember our trip when from JB to Perlis?
Yeah.
You know how cramped we got?
I agree with you.
Our knees are like, oh man, I can't walk properly.
I stood up on my back for some parts of the journey also lah. Yeah, correct.
So scooters, you can actually change when you're riding, right? You can either put it here or you can shift back. Then you bend your knee or forward. So I have three different positions. I change all the time when I'm training.
So far, with this bike, have you faced any mechanical or technical issues with the engines or any of the hardwares?
Okay, when I first got it, it kept stalling when I was at low speed. So when there, they changed the throttle body. So that solved it. So I never had the issue again, but that was $900.
Whoa. $900? Okay. My gosh, very expensive, huh?
Yeah. So I think most throttle bodies are around that kind of pricing. So the hydraulic, there's this is called a tilt lock, the hydraulic tilt lock. I've experienced problems before the last time. It's because I don't ride it enough. So the thing seized.
Yeah. I see.
So I had one very silly kind of thing. I went to JB and the thing, so when I started, it just wouldn't disengage. So I started in JB.
So you're stuck there, you cannot corner.
No, once you cannot move on. You cannot move
off. Can't even move also. Okay.
The moment the bike moves off, it will automatically release. So there's this feature, but yeah. Because the thing locked, the bike couldn't move.
Oh.
Yeah, so I had to stuck in JB, had to call the tow truck Singapore, they come in. I think the tow bag was $350 a day. So I waited there, $350. I brought back to the workshop to solve the problem, was $80.
Oh my gosh, the towing more expensive than the
So but that was my bad because I didn't ride it enough and I didn't service it enough. So now because that was a short trip, you're thinking no problem, just going to
Yeah.
But prior to long trips, I make sure everything is done.
Basically, do a check before you.
Yeah, so I just came back now. I have new tires and.
Yeah, especially for this particular bikes, the three wheelers, because it's not easily found in Malaysia.
Yeah.
So you know you don't have experience or knowledgeable mechanics to actually repair this one.
Yeah.
This kind of bikes, somehow rather. Come back into Singapore.
That's
the downside of
The downside of having something so rare.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm. In Singapore, there's no issue because the people doing it.
Yeah, there's so many workshop that specialize in scooters.
Yeah.
Mm. Speaking of rare, do you get no looks or questions when you're out on the road with the Fuko 500?
Actually, no.
Not really.
Yeah, but some people do look at it. Yeah.
Because for me, I'm wow, you know, this is like something rare. And for me, if I were to see you on the road, I don't even know you. I would just look. Maybe ask you, hey bro, this bike, power.
The Can-Am Spider, if people stop and talk.
I had that. That one we're trying to get also, if possible. If any Can-Am, contact us. Okay, so Chris, what's your maintenance schedule like for the Fuko Gilera?
Same, every 5,000.
5,000. Even though you like ready ride the bike lah.
Yeah, so I just keep to 5,000.
I see.
Belting wise,
same time to change. I think belting is, what is it, 12,000 for norm? For scooters?
I thought 20, because I always change at 20.
Or maybe 20, I. Then again, you know, this bike is now
your weekend ride.
I had it for 6 over years.
Uh-huh.
Mm.
The mileage is 30 over 1,000. When I bought it, it was 12,000 on the mileage. So at least I put more on this one.
Shala.
Yeah.
Only 30,000?
Yeah, 30.
Shala, my Honda already 50,000.
30, maybe coming to 40,000, but it's going to be here for a long time, this bike.
Yeah, that's why. Oh, yeah, because this is a weekend rider. I ride it almost every day.
Yeah.
Right. So in 1 year, I already chalked up like 30,000-40,000. For the 6 years, you already ride this bike. Does the hydraulic give you any problem besides the issue?
No, on the move, I've heard, you know, before, but thank God, touch wood, nothing for me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So when I'm turning, nothing ever seizes. It just feels. It feels like exactly like a two-wheeler. You actually hardly feel the
three-wheel.
Yeah,
it's damn stable.
You don't feel it, but the absolute confidence when you're moving, because this guy is powerful, right?
Mm-mm.
So the moment you, even at 100, when at 120, you throttle, it comes straight away. Yeah, so everything about it, you just...
Pickup is very fast?
It's fast, but my Vespa GTS is faster on the pickup.
Maybe because it's heavy.
It's strange. Yeah. But it is ample and good enough for everything. Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah. This is just.
I mean, it's a three wheeler. Why you want to go fast on it? Okay lah. So Chris, final question: what's the best memories you have with the Fuko 500? I think you have a lot lah.
I just like riding it. Even for. Going for prata at night or whatever.
Don't mind me asking. Are there like any groups dedicated to the Fuko?
We had a few of the guys, but then we haven't done much together. Come think of it, I'm gonna reach out to you guys.
yes, please reach out to Chris.
All the Fuko guys, call me. Let's get together and we
talk about the Fuko.
Yeah, poison each other, spend money.
Okay, Chris. We want to thank you so much, you know, for sharing both of your rides, your Adiva and your Gilera. They're really, really wonderful machines. Any riders who want to review their bikes with us, do get in touch with us. And just leave your comments down below. Anything else you want to say?
I think... no lah. You already said my.
You should bring your dad here lah. Your dad will love this, man.
I will show this video to my dad.
Kau pun like sakit hati, Yuan. Yeah. I know his dad lah actually. So yeah.
Okay, I have coffee with your dad.
Okay, guys, that's it for the vlog, and we will see you in the next one.
Thank you.